our last lesson, we took a look at how to choose your website hosting and then get in and install WordPress so you can begin building your website. But what if you weren't ready to choose your web host? Or maybe you're working with a client and don't have a hosting solution that can handle a staging environment. This is where taking advantage of local development can be super helpful. In this lesson, we're going to uncover a number of options that are out there when it comes to building locally and help you recognize which solution is best for you so you can make a decision. Hi, I'm Ryan, and it's so good to have you with us again at the Learning Hub. No matter whether you're still new to WordPress or you've already built a few websites, having an awareness of local development environments is vital, giving you so much more flexibility with how and where you build your website. So, if I'm going to eventually need to subscribe to an online hosting platform, why would I choose to build locally? Here are three reasons. Number one, cost. Having the ability to quickly and easily spin up a website with so little fuss and very little or no cost is a no-brainer. Most of the tools we're going to mention are free to use or at least offer a free option, saving you hosting costs while you build out your website, especially when you're getting started and don't have something ready to launch. Number two is performance. Because you're not relying on an internet connection to connect to your web server, building your local site is often much faster. This also means that even when you don't have access to Wi-Fi, you can still fire up and work on your local website. And the third one is low risk. Local development allows you the freedom to try out new plugins and themes, perform updates, and even make modifications without the stress of breaking something. This gives an added benefit that you alternatively wouldn't have if you were working on your live website. Test everything works on your local environment and then confidently make those updates on your live site. To work with WordPress on your local computer, there are some fundamental tools that are necessary to actually install and run. WordPress relies on the programming language PHP, a database, namely MySQL, and a server that can run these. There are a number of solutions that package all of these together to make our job easier, but actually knowing which one to choose really comes down to your preference. There are three main categories that you can choose from, and whichever appeals to you the most is probably what I'd suggest you go with. The first category of local development tools we're going to mention is graphical user interface, or GUI apps. These are, generally speaking, like any other app you would download and install on your local computer. Once installed, you can simply begin building with WordPress. Everything is so nicely packaged together with these that there's really no configuration necessary. An example of apps in this category are Desktop Server, Local WP, and DevKinsta. All of these apps can be downloaded for free and used to build out a website on your local computer. Local WP, or previously known as Local by Flywheel, is developed by the team at Flywheel, which is now owned by WP Engine. Similarly, DevKinsta is developed by the team at Kinsta. If you were to choose one of these hosting solutions, these apps provide additional features and functionality by connecting you to your hosting account, giving you the ability to push and pull your website from your live hosting, saving you the need to use a migration plugin. Desktop Server, however, isn't associated with any particular host, but still is a viable option for working locally. Overall, these GUI apps offer a complete solution for getting started developing locally. Managing multiple sites is so simple and they're so easy to use. If, however, you like to look under the hood, so to speak, you might opt for one of these next ones. The next category of local development tools is referred to as stack-based apps. These basically provide you with a suite of elements, like what we mentioned earlier, the necessary server running PHP and a database manager that will enable you to install an app such as WordPress. Without going too technical, you'll hear a lot of these referred to by similar names: MAMP, LAMP, and WAMP. These stand for, firstly, the operating system: M for Mac, L for Linux, W for Windows, A is for the Apache server, M is for the MySQL database, and then P for the PHP scripting language interpreter. Another take on these stack style apps is XAMPP, or XAMPP, some may say it's pronounced. However you say it, it's spelt XAMPP. This is a cross-platform solution, hence the X, that although appears in theory to be similar to our other similar sounding friends, it has some differences, including the second P, which stands for the Perl programming language interpreter. To sum up these stack-based options, you'll have more control over your server settings with these tools, but you'll find there is more involved in setup and configuration. If you're wanting to venture down this path, we'll be digging deeper into one of these in a few lessons time. The final category of local development tools we have available to us are command line tools. These don't come with user-friendly installers. All the setup is done via your terminal or command prompt. If you're someone who's used to working in the command line, this might be your go-to, digging into technologies such as Docker and Vagrant. As you can see in my example here, there is plenty going on and plenty that can go wrong. But if it's what you're comfortable with, then there's huge flexibility with what you can achieve. So hopefully this gives you a feel for the available options that are out there for local development and helps you make a decision on which one might be right for you. As always, if you haven't yet, make sure you join Elementor's vibrant community and check out the academy and blog. Catch you in lesson 9.